Happy Valentine's Day. I'm sick as frick. I'm supposed to be at my shift. What rhymes with shift? I am supposed to be working right now, but I am sick. So this is what's been going on with me recently, right? Last week was fucking chaos with work, up the ass. We're already starting off with the A word at the start of this thing. That's okay. It's just crazy people calling out. We're just got a huge influx of clientele for some reason, and I don't understand why. It looks like this week's about to be the same thing. Monday was like crazy. And then Tuesday, it was crazy also. And then in the middle of the shift, I got what I later learned was called like a visual aura or like a fucking ocular migraine. I'm sure I've gotten them confused. I am not a scientist. I am a mere Mayo Clinic WebMD conspiracy theorist. I Google, and so I don't really remember. I don't absorb information. I just know something's wrong with me. Middle of the shift, I was like in the middle of a phone call, and then on my left eye, I got like this like colorful zigzag blurry, and I've had them before, but I've paid no mind to it. I think I've had them like twice before. But I've paid no mind to it because it goes away, whatever. Talk to my coworker. She's like, yeah, that's usually what I see before I have a migraine. I've never had a migraine. That spooked me a little bit, you know? So of course I Google it, and that's when I find out that I am having a migraine. It's just a different kind of migraine. They're painless, which, great, painless. But I still can't fucking see out of my eyeball. I guess my like eye cells, whatever, I can't think straight right now, are firing like a million miles per second, and they become blurry, and like I just, sometimes you can feel like confused and grogginess afterwards. I haven't really paid attention much to my symptoms after they've ended, but I just know I have them. I now know it's because I'm stressed. And listen, I handle stress very well. Stress is one of the things that I'm like, I handle stress very well. At least I thought I did until this very moment. The entire week was insane. Like it was just day after day after day after day after day of just like mind-numbingly, literally, busyness, running back and forth. It was to the point where my body physically couldn't catch up with my mind. Hold up, I got this the other day. I need a zen moment. My dogs fucking hate the spray, anything that sprays. Sorry ladies, it smells good. I just got to a point where my brain would tell me to do something, but my body just wasn't following it. My body has slowly given up, at least for the time being, to catch up and to be fast. And you know what? That is something I have accepted. And if that's the way it's gonna have to be so as to not push myself, then that's the way it's gonna have to be. I will play catch up later, whether that means paying another consequence later. Just kind of accepted that's just, I'm gonna have to listen to my body at this point. Like I can't push my body any further than I thought I could push it. Because then I end up with shit like this. So after that migraine that I had, that I Googled, I kind of have head pressure, like right here. And just the entire week right after that incident on Tuesday, I've been feeling this head pressure, and I feel it right now. On Saturday, I developed a sore throat. Usually they go away pretty fast, and so I take like some Tylenol, Advil, whatever the fuck I take to deal with it. Yesterday during my shift, at the end of the shift actually, it got worse. I couldn't swallow, my stomach started killing me, my headache was more obvious, because I can usually ignore these headaches, but you know, I guess once you slow down, it's just kind of like, hey, you remember me? Yeah, kind of didn't want to, but there you are. I forgot I had this, I'm just gonna put it on. I told my boss about it, like at that very instant, because I'm like, yo, this doesn't feel great. This doesn't feel very poggers or very cash money. I'm gonna warn them, and I'm gonna update them and stuff like that just to see if I can even come in on Monday, which of course happens to be Valentine's Day. I'm already like super like worried that it seems like I'm just gonna try to call out, but I made it very clear I wasn't going to call out. I just needed to fucking realize what's going on with me. I'm very stuffy. Here I am. They're giving me the day off today, even though I kind of tried to fight it. I'm like, this is really necessary. Like, I know I'm gonna feel fine. Like, there's something deep in my soul, in my spirit, that I was gonna be okay. Whatever the definition of being okay is. So this morning, I'm feeling better. I don't feel the stomach shit. I'm still in the stuffy nose. The sore throat's still kind of there. The head pressure, of course, is still there. And I Googled that part because headaches and me, we don't really clash. We're not friends, we're not buddies. I don't really know them that well. I call them stress headaches. How does everyone know that I'm stressed but me? I'm learning so much about myself. I'm not an established adult. It's Valentine's Day. and I'm spending it sick. I don't know what I'm gonna do today. Just probably gonna chill. Maybe try to stay off my phone, which is impossible because I'm very nosy and I like to stick with what's going on today. Let's change scenery. Do you want to hold my phone? I said hold my phone. Do you want to hold my phone? You said yes. You gotta stick with it, girl. You gotta stick with it. So just catch up on some of the things I kind of left. Don't move it. Some of the things I just kind of left, like, at the end of this, I just kind of left a frayed string. I don't know what that means. I don't even know if that makes sense. That Qdoba burrito, when I said, hopefully it's memorable. Oh, yeah. You bet your fucking ass it was memorable. It was all rice. Barely got any chicken. And let me tell you, when my boss gifted me so graciously this Qdoba burrito, she said, that's a fat burrito. That's one big mass of a burrito. Looked at it and I was like, Chipotle is definitely giving me a bigger burrito. They overfill that shit to the brim and I, you know, but this burrito was like, it's like I didn't ask for anything. I asked for guacamole, cojito cheese, lemon lime rice, chicken, lettuce, corn salsa, red salsa. I stacked this shit. I like my burritos stacked. I don't know what they define as a big boy, but that burrito did not look very big to me compared to my Chipotle winners, you know? It's all rice. It was literally all rice. I got maybe 3 pieces of chicken. I don't even know where the guacamole went. I don't even know if there was sour cream in there. It was very underwhelming, and I had rice and a tortilla for lunch. And the rice didn't even taste like anything, to be honest. Not gonna let this be like my first, second, because I already had that taco bowl, whatever. I'm not gonna let this stick as an impression. I'm sure they're great, and I'm sure my experience could go significantly better. They're gonna have to take the L on this one. I was promised a thick boy, and I wasn't given a thick boy. That's totally fine. It was memorable, just not in the way that I wanted it to be. My nails are doing great. Thank you, honey. My nails are doing great. I had to trim them because they were getting pretty long. I don't have a filer, so I used a stone. We went hiking once, and my roommate found this, like, flat stone in the river, and we still have it, and I filed my nails with it. I did pretty good. My nails, don't mean to flip you off, my nails are growing significantly. To treat this like a makeup product. I'm never able to let my nails grow just because they break so easily at this job. You like my nails because I get to scratch you more efficiently, huh? As for the purse that I spent an entire week looking for, went to 4 or 5 thrift stores. Yes, and the very last one I went to, good yawn, baby. The very last one I went to, I finally got it. I described briefly this purse was mushy. I'm sorry that wasn't a very good descriptive term, but this is what I mean. This is her. She, let me go get my other bag. This was my baby 2 summers ago. This was my ride or die. And as you can tell, they both have about the same built. It's mushy. I put it down and it'll like melt onto the seat. And that's what this thing did. I like flung it around, had my it girl moment. I put it down, it would melt to the seat. Now I can be glamorous. I tightened the straps because, I don't know, I kind of was looking for like the one strap moment, but I think I'll eventually want to put it back to like the side strap, even though I do wear it like this. But maybe I'll go back to the longer version, just maybe if I get tired of it. But she's cute. She's simple. She's perfect. Let me tell you, that one Goodwill store, actually it wasn't Goodwill, that one ARC store, I was overwhelmed. ARC delivers. The bag section is just an entire wall's worth, and it is marvelous for someone like me. She's pushing my phone. Stop pushing my phone. It's marvelous. It's marvelous.
You going to say hello? You going to say hello?
I've never tried these before, so I'm going to try them now. They're packaged very nicely. Coffee's best companion. Coffee's best companion. I don't drink coffee, so I'll never figure that out. Probably broke. I'm gonna eat the ones that fell. Not broken. Kind of. Matcha latte, guacamole, and chips from Chipotle. God, everyone fucking loves me today. I'm so tired of the snow. Why can't something else fall like sunshine?
Sassy.
I am shoveling and I have boots on this time. No Croc shenanigans.
Heavy up. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Heavy up. Yeah. Heavy up. Yeah, ready? Ah, I
I came for a prescription, but ended up in the dollar section. Came for a prescription, ended up in the bags. Pizza, 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 pizza.